take a look at the Cape and let's theorize how it works here. There was a video on this channel on Rake that looked into another possibility of how it affected the rake of the car. But this time around, we will focus more towards the front nose and its aerodynamics here. Regulation has recent front nose cone designs being more angular towards the front and away from the once trendy raised nose cone design. Today, there are two types, one that is narrow, like on the McLaren and on the Mercedes-AMG. And as for the rest, they look like a flat plank and a little bit wider, yeah. The narrow front nose variant look more towards opening up for more volume and probably work with the Cape, as earlier use of the Cape by Mercedes-AMG ran a narrow nose cone, and then McLaren again also ran a narrow front nose cone. We will get to possibilities as to why this is the case. Let's start with a clean contemporary front nose. We can see here that it is angled downwards. With the top going downwards, the under nose cone too follows suit, leaving a large space underneath the chassis between the front wheels. The frontal raised chassis here. Because this angle is blocking straight airflow, the air that passes the lowest point of the under nose cone towards the underneath of the front chassis, what happens here is that expanding shape will slow down airflow. Air velocity here is important, as it will influence a critical part of the car's aerodynamic that affects the floor ground effect, and that is the splitter. The yellow drone here is a reference to low pressure air by drag, which will be integral in explaining the next example. What Formula One teams have done here is added some sort of fin or fins. Fins under or at the lower section of the nose cone and to a certain extent the lower front of the chassis. The shape and position of these fins are drawing air inwards, yeah, towards the yellow or low pressure expanding area under the front chassis. This is most likely to recover lost air velocity underneath the higher part or ceiling of the front chassis of the under nose cone. How does the Cape come into play? Again, conspiracy theory and theoretically, of course. What the Cape does is it separates the airflow from the under nose cone expanding area and under the front raised chassis. It behaves like a barrier to prevent the lower airflow from being affected by the area that slows down airflow. Again, that expanding area under the front raised chassis. This would result in airflow not slowing down and maybe even accelerated by the low pressure area above the Cape and below the under nose cone, or in between from the Cape, where the Cape is, and where the under chassis is, yeah, underneath the nose cone. This could also be the reason why some teams, namely Mercedes-AMG and McLaren, choose to run that narrow front nose cone. Mercedes-AMG is looking a bit naughty, yeah, if I must say so. Use it to control airflow towards the upper Cape area and reduce drag that won't cause turbulence after the Cape, but maybe just enough low pressure to accelerate the flow underneath the Cape without causing too much turbulence, so that the airflow towards the splitter wouldn't be disrupted too much. Yeah. Looking at Mercedes-AMG's Cape, the opening here certainly looked to try and energize air velocity, a bit like the rear diffuser. This looks to be evident that the Cape does center around retaining or accelerating air velocity underneath the front nose and front chassis, so it could have an impact on the splitter area. The splitter obviously has been designed to divert air and influence the flow. So the higher velocity air travels, the more influence the splitter has towards the underflow. What is evident here is Mercedes' understanding on the design of the cape. You can see how they designed it different from the others. They pull it all the way back past the front wheel center line, close to the front splitter. Yeah. So they obviously know they need to boost the air velocity towards the splitter in order to have ground effect, or to have more ground effect. So the opening of the front nose that may slow down airflow is the reason why they created the cape, so that this particular opening will not affect their desired airflow velocity underneath the car towards the splitter. So I think this is what they're doing with the cape.